Welcome everybody, and welcome to Odyssey Racing League. This is your highlight reel for our ACC GT3 Euro Series Round 6 at KYALAMI. This will be exciting stuff here. Quickly before we start our race, I'm going to skip the sponsors this time, get straight to the important stuff. On Saturday, November 12th, we are having a 12-hour charity stream. Anyone is welcome. It's on ACC. There's going to be 7 races, all unique races. They're going to have their own individual themes, and there's prizes for the winners. So if you come out, show up, race with us, engage, be a part of it, you could win something. As well, it's going to be a lot of fun. It's for a great cause. You can learn more about it in our server. Our Discord server link is below in the description of this video. So yes, please check it out. Please come out. Even if you can't participate in all the races, come and watch a couple. Come and be in a couple. Whatever you can do helps. Without further ado, let's check out this EU series, KYALAMI Grand Prix circuits. So we'll just run down the list of cars. We got Cayne Wagener, Chris Rees, Gianni DeMarchi, Bonus Charles, Neil Berrevoets, Shane Rees, Ian Demler, David Blyth, Durasso, and Nightshade on the grid this week. This should be a lot of fun. I was told by the guys that there was just absolute chaos happening here, that these guys made it a fun, fun race. Wagener getting a really solid start there in that redneck gentleman Audi. I love that livery. It's so clean. It's so unique at the same time. Now Chris Rees not letting him get away. He's keeping up close as he can. They're both pulling away from the pack. You got DeMarchi in the background. He's just doing his best in his tier, or in his amp class position of fourth. He got passed by Bonus Charles. Good start to the race there. Three Audis in the lead. All three Audis in the lead. We said it before, but this league, Odyssey Racing League, loves their Audis and BMWs. Lap 2, we have an overtake by Berrevoets and Demler. Overtake by Berrevoets on Demler. Like a pretty sweet livery he's got going on there. I think it's one of those stock ones, but it almost looks like a custom made it. He was just showing us that one last week. I love these guys getting creative with their own livery. It's really good stuff here. Lap 3, Berrevoets went a little wide there, but we got Demler passing Charles. Oh, some contact there. Unfortunately, Rees has been knocked out, and he's going to be in the back of the pack, or close to it. I know Nightshade actually started from the pit, so he's going to be a little bit behind the rest of them. Got Rees and Berrevoets battling it out for P7 on lap 6. It's amazing that even 6 laps in, these guys are all this close to each other. Usually the grid really thins out at this point. Lap 7, John is looking for that pass on Rees, which he seems to get it as he's on the inside of that turn. Looking for Johnny, but then it's turn 3. Who's going to have the advantage here? It looks like side by side, Johnny gets it. Wow, that's usually you get the guy on the inside of turn 3 is going to have the advantage, but Johnny is just flying. Chris doesn't want to let him go. Chris gets that draft and he starts to try and go side by side into the turn 6, I think that is. Lap 9, we have Shane Rees overtaking David Blyth. How's that going to go for Shane? Trying to find that space. David just gives it up. He's like, not going to defend against you, man. Too much pace there. Berrevoets and David Blyth having a bit of a battle now. Those guys battling it out for second position. Don't know where Wagener is, but he is definitely ahead there. This grid has definitely shuffled quite a bit. I'm assuming some guys have taken their lap pit stops at this point. We'll shuffle it up. Berrevoets in third, or second, I should say, with Blyth in the background there in third. Lap 17, we got a battle here between Cayne Wagener and Ian Demler. Chris Rees says his nine laps behind, he may have bailed from this race, unless he suffered some heavy damage a couple times. Cayne Wagener looking good in that Odyssey Esports livery. I love that design, very clean and straight to the point. It suits the league very, very well. You got Bonus Charles is going to overtake DeMarchi here in a moment. Looks like DeMarchi overshoots that turn a bit, giving Bonus the perfect opportunity to take it, unless he actually gave it up. I'm not actually sure. Hard to tell there. But Charles gets to run away with that one. Yeah, Nightshade and DeRosso. So I think this is what I have to be watching out for. I think these guys, like last week, were just being hooligans. And after some private discussions, I said I would follow up with this. It turns out they were just messing around and having a good time. And they weren't SA farming like I suggested, but they might as well have been doing that. So we'll see how they handle this portion of the race now. I feel like they're going to take up and occupy overlapping or overtaking for the rest of the race. And at lap 23, I believe this will go to around 31 laps. So now we got to watch their crap for the next 8 laps or so. Next time I see them do this, I'm just not going to do a highlight reel because they're going to take up so much of it. Lap 24, another overtake. Nightshade on DeRosso. Let's see if the next clip is still these guys. Lap 25, accident by Nightshade. What happens? Oh, he's spun out. And it looks like DeRosso has hit him. And it looks like Nightshade may have a bit of suspension damage. Not really sure if I'm seeing that right or if he just has really dramatic camber. Lap 25, DeRosso gets the pass in Nightshade. I think we see Cayne Wagener coming from the background there. So I wonder if they're going to give up the position or just keep battling and hold up the track. We'll find out here shortly. Also putting the pressure on Nightshade. Another overtake from one of them. Looks like Cayne had actually gotten around them, so now it's just Demler who's got to get around them next. Two wide side by side down the start straight around turn one as they enter turn two. Let's see what happens into turn three. They're still sort of side by side. Let's see if Nightshade can hold this line together. Nope, DeRosso ran away with it. A little bit of a slow section there on that turn, on that chicane. DeRosso seems to give the position to Nightshade. Maybe so they can continue battling. Lap 29. looks like De Rosso is politely waiting for Nightshade to get back on the track so they can keep battling each other like crazy. Nightshade just can't hold it on the tarmac, keeps going into the grass. Not sure if Nightshade is aware that this is not a landscaping simulator, rather a racing simulator. I don't remember the last time Ferrari made a lawnmower. De Rosso, wide out of that exit. Very impressive lines there from De Rosso. They chase each other down the start straight. No, that's not the start straight. Race finish. Cayne Wagener, your race champion for the Euro Series. It looks like, trying to see, Charles is looking to try and unlap before the end, but no, that's not going to happen. So your podium winners for the Pro Series is Cayne Wagener, Shane Rees, and Ian Demler. For the AM Series, it's David Blyth, Neil Berrevoets, and Gianni DeMarchi. Congratulations to your winners. And I will put this back onto the ending screen now. So I just want to repeat myself from the beginning of this this highlight reel. We have the charity stream on the 12th. Hopefully you guys can be there. Hopefully you guys watch this before then and actually get the info about it. If you are new to this series, check the Discord link in the description. That's where you can find out everything about this league, about the sponsors, about the racing opportunities. It is a beginner-friendly league, and we have this charity series on Saturday, which is a good opportunity to kind of get a feel for what the league is like. The more people that show up, the better, obviously. And there's prizes. And it's for a good cause. What's not to love? You don't have to race all of them. Race a couple. Come have a good time. And then you don't have to race all of them. No big commitments. Anyways, without further ado, we hope to see you there. And we will see you on the next highlight reel. Have a lovely day.